Hey guys, welcome back to K-World for the last three episodes of the K-drama Hellbound. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to the video. 4 years have passed since the death of Jung-jae. Monsters from hell still appear to incinerate people. If a person commits suicide, after receiving the decree, his soul was brought back by the monsters and incinerated. Jung-chul is now the president of the New Truth Society. He sends some deacons, including Yoo-ji, to a broadcasting station to review a documentary they've been working on the New Truth Society. Yoo-ji comments that the documentary should not be in a way that attracts any public sympathy for the sinners. Young-jae, who is the co-producer, retorts at his comment, and Yoo-ji quickly notices that he is against the New Truth Society. Young-jae admits to it and explains that the New Truth Society and the Arrowheads are committing more crimes than doing good to the society by harassing not only the victims, but also their families. Jung-won, who is the other co-producer, gets particularly irritated by Young-jae when he remarks that they are turning the world into hell. Young-jae's chief tries to calm the situation. Once the deacons leave, he lashes out at Young-jae for the rudeness. He orders Young-jae to complete the changes the deacons requested within the day, even though he protests that he needs to go to the hospital to see his newborn baby. He gets a call from his wife So-young, and he assures her that he will visit her as soon as he's done with the editing. He goes to see his junior Mi-suk to get her help with the editing. He looks through a different project Mi-suk is working on. Young-jae goes to get the script of the documentary which is needed for the editing from Jung-won. He notices a strange business card on Jung-won's desk with an address written on it. Jung-won quickly snatches it from him and refuses to help Young-jae with the editing. Jung-won quickly leaves, saying he has to meet with his wife. So-young, on the other hand, sneaks in her phone to the intensive care unit to record her newborn for Young-jae. But to her shock, she sees the angel prophesizing her baby would die in 3 days. While Young-jae is on his way to the hospital, he gets a worried call from Jung-won's wife, saying she can't reach her husband. Young-jae assures her that he's probably hanging out somewhere, but remembers the strange address he found on the business card. He goes to the address and finds Jung-won. Jung-won refuses to talk at first, but finally confesses that he received a prophecy. He has asked for the help of an organization named Soto to make it look like he disappeared without a trace, so that his family will be protected from both Arrowheads and New Truth Societies. He begs Young-jae to leave, warning Soto members will harm him if he witnesses what is going to happen. The monsters appear from the water and kill Jung-won as Young-jae watches helplessly. Young-jae, who is still in shock, gets dragged out of the water by Soto members. One of the members is a panelist on the documentary Mi-suk was working on, and he warns him to forget what he just saw. Young-jae also sees Hye-jin among them, while one of the members injects him to make him unconscious. So-young, on the other hand, search for cases related to newborn babies on the New Truth Society's app, but finds none. Young-jae wakes up in his car the next morning and goes straight to the hospital to see his wife. He tries to explain that the editing took a long time than expected, without bringing up about Jung-won. Without a word, So-young hands him the video with the prophecy. Yoo-ji, with the help of the police, search the place Jung-won was killed. He suspects that Jung-won received a decree and was hiding. The police receive a surveillance footage of Jung-won's car being captured near Incheon Harbor and confirms that he has fled from the country due to gambling debts. Yoo-ji is not convinced by the police's claim and notices the Soto member's business card Jung-won had near the bank. One of the deacons informs him that a man who is in hiding after receiving the decree has been tracked down. So he leaves immediately. At work, Young-jae is still shaken by the recent events. His chief informs him about Jung-won fleeing the country because of his gambling debts. Young-jae remembers the Soto member whom he recognized and rushed to Mi-suk to get his number. Young-jae learns that the Soto member he saw the other night is a sociology professor Gong Hong-jin at Hankook University and goes to meet him. As he walks to Hong-jin's office, a group of men drags Young-jae in and remind him of the warning they gave to forget Jung-won's incident. Hong-jin explains to him about their organization and that humans have the right to die alone. So they are protecting the victims who receive the decree from both the New Truth Society and the Arrowheads. They track the possible people who receive the decree by hacking into the New Truth app. Young-jae asks for Hong-jin's help and shows him the video recording of his baby receiving the decree. Meanwhile, the New Truth members try to get a video statement from the man who was in hiding. Yoo-ji notices another Soto business card among the man's belongings. He questions the man about the card. At his prophesized time, the members take him to their headquarters and broadcast the moment he goes to hell. They even get his family to witness it. Yoo-ji calls for an immediate committee meeting. He plays the statement video of the man who received the decree. In exchange for not letting his daughter witness his demonstration, the man confesses about getting a call from the Soto members. Soto members have offered to help him disappear before the New Truth Society could find him. He reveals that he was contacted by Hye-jin. Jong-chul convinced the committee that seeking the assistance of the police would not be good enough. He gives Yoo-ji full authority to use every means possible to take down the Soto organization. Hong-jun takes Young-jae to meet Hye-jin. Hye-jin assures him that they have deleted the surveillance footage from the hospital. She also adds that even the New Truth Society would want to cover up Young-jae's case. Because a newborn baby hasn't committed any sins, the baby's decree goes against their doctrine of only sinners get the decree. When Young-jae doesn't seem to be convinced, Hye-jin reveals to him that Jin-soo, the founder of the New Truth Society, was subjected to a demonstration, but it got covered up. Jin-soo made the people believe him by broadcasting Jung-ja's demonstration. So in order to make people believe that New Truth Society is falsely accusing people, she suggests broadcasting the demonstration of his baby. Young-jae lash out at them for trying to use his baby on their own advantage, just as the New Truth would do. Hye-jin retort back at saying they'd disguise the baby's death if that's what he wants, so he could return to editing documentaries on New Truth Society. She gives him their business card saying to let them know his decision. Yoo-ji gets a group of arrowheads to hunt down Soto members. They track down one of the members and torture him to confess about the leader of the organization. When the arrowheads try to torture his wife, the member finally gives in and confesses about Hong-jun being their leader. Hong-jun tries to explain to Young-jae that Hye-jin feels responsible for the crimes both the arrowheads and the New Truth Society commits because she couldn't stop the broadcast of Jung-ja's demonstration. When Young-jae refuses to ride with him, Hong-jun confesses that his daughter also received a decree. On their way to the beach, an angel suddenly appears and prophesizes her death in the next 30 seconds. Shocked by the sudden appearance of the monsters, Hong-jun loses control of the car and gets into an accident. By the time he gets out of the car, his daughter is already dead. Hong-jun reveals that he felt relieved that no one witnessed the prophecy or her death. Young-jae goes home and tells So-yun about the meeting he had with Hye-jin and Hong-jun. Hong-jun gets kidnapped by the arrowheads on his way back. They have brought the member they attacked earlier as well. The arrowheads tell Hong-jun that all they need is the records of the navigation system in his car, so they can track all the places Hong-jun has been. The arrowheads incinerate Hong-jun alive right in front of the other Soto member. Hye-jin tries calling Hong-jun and sees some of the arrowhead members speeding towards the place she lives. Irritated by arrowheads struggling to catch her, Yoo-ji and his fellow deacon also go after Hye-jin and manage to catch her. But she tasers them and escape. The next morning, the incinerated bodies of Hong-jun and the fellow Soto member were hanged at the main gate of the Hankook University, with a board saying they are sinners. Young-jae learns about the news at work and watch a video exposing Hye-jin as the main activist of the Soto organization. He gets a call from Hye-jin, and she informs Young-jae that he needs to decide soon or they won't be able to help him. She informs him that the arrowheads and the New Truth Society work together. Young-jae tries contacting So-yun, but we see her walking to the headquarters of the New Truth Society. She sends him a text saying she's meeting with the New Truth Society deacons because she needs to know why their baby got the decree. So-yun shows the video of the decree to Yoo-ji. Yoo-ji assures her that he needs to discuss the matter internally before giving her a proper answer. On his way out, he urges the staff not to let So-yun leave the premises. He calls Jong-chul requesting an immediate committee meeting. Jong-chul orders to separate the mother and the child and bring in everyone who knows about the video. In the meantime, Young-jae texts So-yun warning the deacons are going to harm her and the baby and to get out of there immediately. Just then a group of deacons comes into the room and takes the baby away from So-yun. Young-jae, Hye-jin, and a group of men manage to sneak into the New Truth Society's building. They arrive just in time when So-yun's baby gets forcefully taken away. Hye-jin and her team fight the deacons and they manage to escape. She takes Young-jae and family to a shabby place where she is hiding another person who has received the decree. Hye-jin convinces So-yun to agree to the broadcast of her baby's demonstration. The man volunteers to broadcast it saying he has the experience. We then see that he was the former livestreamer of the arrowheads doing. During the livestream, Hye-jin tells the New Truth Society to stop deluding people by calling the prophecies a god's punishment. The arrowhead livestreamer, who is Dong-wook, sneaks out of the house and informs Jong-chul about Hye-jin and others, but doesn't give their location, only that they are at his house. He adds that he's being a faithful follower of the New Truth doctrine, but received a prophecy himself. The baby's demonstration is 5 minutes before his, and asks for Jong-chul's interpretation. Jong-chul and the committee convince Dong-wook that God has made a mistake by condemning the baby to hell. So God will use Dong-wook to cover it up, which means Dong-wook is the Messiah of God. Dong-wook lashes out at Jong-chul when he asks for his location, but tells him he'll leave a clue to find him. After he hangs up, Dong-wook throws away the phone. Dong-wook attack the men who come to assist Hye-jin to relocate Young-jae and his family to a safer place. Because it's taking too long and Hye-jin can't reach the team, Young-jae goes to check. He sees the dead men and realizes that it's Dong-wook's doing. Dongwook confesses that he is the Messiah and has been assigned by God to cover up God's mistake. So he will kill Young-jae, his wife, and Hye-jin, and would cover up the baby's demonstration just as God wants. Young-jae tasers him and runs back shouting for So-yeon and Hye-jin to run. Dongwook pushes Young-jae down the stairs and because the time is nearing, he runs to kill So-yeon and Hye-jin. So-yeon runs out of the house while Hye-jin fights Dongwook. So-yeon sees a group of people, and she tells them that her baby is bound to hell. She asks them to witness the demonstration. An officer sees a video of So-yeon's confession and shows it to Yoo-ji. So-yeon leaves the baby in an open area, and when the monsters appear, So-yeon grabs the baby. Young-jae and Hye-jin also try to fight the monsters. Realizing they can't fight the monsters, Young-jae and So-yeon cover their baby in between them and let the monsters incinerate them all. To everyone's surprise, they hear a baby's cry, and they realize the baby has survived the incineration. Dongwook tries to kill the baby, but Hye-jin fights him. When Dongwook gets back, the three monsters appear and incinerate him. Hye-jin then takes the baby. As she walks away, Yoo-ji, the deacons, and the police get there, but the people stop them from reaching Hye-jin. An elderly man shouts at Yoo-ji, calling the New Truth Society a liar. He heavily beat the elderly man, disregarding the presence of the police. So he gets taken into police custody. Hye-jin gets in a taxi and asks the taxi driver to get her as far as possible. We then see in Jung-ja's house, the glass box in which her incinerated body is kept gets shattered. Her body ash gets reassembled, and Jung-ja comes back to life. With that, the drama ends. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time.